the song really blessed me. It said, with long life.
With long life.
But you know, we put emphasis on long life. But I want to put emphasis on the fact that he said that he was satisfied. He will what? Satisfy. It ain't just good that it give you long life. He don't want you to have long life broke, busted, and disgusted. He wants you to have long life when he's satisfied. Amen? And so how many of you all know it's offering time? See, worship just don't stop when we stop singing. This is the part of worship. And when you worship, when you send praises up, God sends what? Blessings down. So you ought to be given with expectation to receive the word. The sower soweth the what? The word. And the reason you ought to have expectation for the word of God is because in the word is vision. And where there's vision, there's provision. He said, my people perish for a lack of what?
Knowledge.
Knowledge. So if you're in lack, it's because you have a lack of knowledge somewhere. Right? And so if you don't have a vision, God can't provide for it. Where there's vision, there's what? Provision. And so if you lack vision, right, then you ought to be in expectation that God is downloading what? Vision. Do y'all follow that?
Amen.
But see, that only happens in the spirit. That only happens in love. See, faith worketh by love, right? He said, give, and it shall be what? Given unto you. Good measure. Shaking it, pressed down, shaking together, running over. Shall men give unto your bosom, right? That scripture is talking about love. So if you love God with all your heart, see, your soul, your mind, then you ought to have expectation, see, that he's going to download vision. And when he downloads that vision, you'll have what? Provision. Now watch this. I want to give you this tidbit because we're in the attitude of what? Giving. Turn in your Bibles if you have them to Genesis. The first chapter. You can keep that. You can keep that. Yeah, there you go. Verse 27. It says, so God created man in his own image. He created he him, both male and female, he created he them. He's talking the spirit realm right here. He's talking the spirit realm. I am a spirit. I have a soul, mind, will, and emotion. And I live in this what? Body. Right? But he's talking to the spirit man. Now I want you to drop down to the next verse, and we're almost here. Verse 29. Not 28, we're going to skip 28, go to 29 for time's sake. And God said, behold, I have given you every herb-bearing seed. What is the herb used for? A herb is used for a savor. It's also used for healing. It's also used for provision. But this is in the spirit realm. The source of the word in the spirit realm. That's the herb-bearing seed that will produce what? It says here, which is upon the face of the earth, and every tree, and which is the fruit of the tree yielding what? Seed. Your offering is a seed. And so you have desires in your heart that God had given you. So that's where you start. Giving God the desires of your heart. And he'll download vision. giving God the desire. He said, I will give you the desires of his heart. The word also says this, my word will never return back to me void. And so when you give today, I'm asking that you go in your pocket with expectation that God will give you what you need in order for you to walk in provision. So you can give a little seed and expect little vision. Or you can give a big seed and expect big vision. Because he said, in according to the measure that you give, he'll give on to what? And so I don't know what you have, but God knows what you have. I don't know what you need, but God knows what you need. Praise God. So my expectation is that you will give on to him. Your desires. And he had turned that mustard seed into an earth-changing situation. And then you can make disciples of him. Because he'll call men onto you. Because Habakkuk says this, write the vision, make it plain. What? That others will pick it up and run with it. So not only is your provision in that seed, the provision for others is in that seed. Amen? Amen. So get excited. Yes. That was a lot, but get excited. Why? Because God is ready to what? Yes. Download. All right. So be ready to receive. Hey, you don't give to get, but because you give, you get. Praise God. Hallelujah. Pastor.
Brother David has spoken well, and we just want to be specific. Brother Marika.
I just want to add to what Brother David has said when he said, when he spoke on vision. I'm going to give you a quick testimony on how that vision thing works. I said about maybe 13 years ago. About 13 years ago, we had bought a home and we didn't have any electricity. Any air. We didn't have any heat. So in the summertime, it was so hot in our home, I had to pick the mattress up and go in the living room so we could be cool. And then in the wintertime, we can see our breath. You know, when we talk, you can see, you know, your air or whatever you want to call it in the wintertime. Now, I could have easily said, you know what, Jessica, let's not pay our tithes, let's save up the money, or let's not give, let's save up the money. And once we get the air conditioner fixed or the heat fixed, then we can go back to tithing. See, we didn't do that. I started buckling down. Us both start buckling down, asking God to give me a vision on how to make this happen. You see what I'm saying? Kept giving. And I remember to this day, she brought this up to me yesterday, a few days ago, while she was talking to her friend Shelly, the name Christine. And you saw her breath in the air because it was cold. She come up with the name Christine Commercial Cleaning Service because we were just now trying to get started in the business. And we kept believing, kept giving. Pastor Hill have these appeals, kept giving, regardless of the circumstances. God kept giving us vision, kept giving me vision. I started seeing things in front of me. I said, you know what, I ain't slowing down here, forget that. God's been too good to us. So we go ahead and go through the fire. You can smell the smoke. So I just kept going. Today, I mean, it's deeper than that, but today, you know, I don't worry about anything. So when Pastor Hill asks for these appeals, I'm gladly to do what I can do. So I'm telling y'all, he didn't ask me to get up here and say this. I'm telling you, that vision thing works. But when all this praying that we do, we have to ask God for vision. As we sowing, as we giving. Giving tithe is a must. But God checks this right here when you're giving. See what I'm saying? That's where it begins with the giving, I believe. Tithing is something we're supposed to do, but then we go beyond this tithe. 10%, it goes beyond 10%. 15, 20. keeping it honest with y'all. Sometimes you have to keep going. You have to just break it all the way down. Say, this ain't nothing but money. God will test you with $5. You see what I'm saying? If you don't do right by this $5, you forget about $500. Don't even think about $5,000. You see what I'm saying? It tests for $5 to see what you're going to do with it. Everybody know what I'm talking about. I come from nothing. That's the honest to God truth. I stopped living with my parents when I was 10 years old. I get up and go all day, but I'm not an emotional person, but talking about death can kind of break you down, but I stopped living with my parents at 10, and it was tough. Only bit, but I had hope, though. At one point in my life, I can honestly say, I didn't know who God was, but I stayed focused. Got the right people in my life. And I said, I'm gonna try this tithe thing and see what this is about. If it don't work, hey, I'll go back to my own ways. But trust me, it worked. I don't know if Pastor Bill remember this. I remember after we gave all our tithes and gave some offerings, I remember reaching in my pocket, handing Pastor Hill $10 from time to time. Because that's all I had. That was my lunch money throughout the week. Remember that, Pastor Hill? I said, can you just come up to you and just, here you go, Pastor Hill. After I done gave, after I did, that was my extra to do whatever I need to do. So what I'm trying to say is, after we pay our tithes and give our offerings and pay all our bills, that little $300-$400 you got left over, if that, ask God to give you a vision on how to flip that. Trust me, He will. But He come in vision. You see what I'm saying? It's in vision. A lot of us want to sit back and, wait on God to just get stand right there in front of us, sit right next to us, count it out in front of us. So you have to be sensitive to the Holy Spirit, and know when He's talking to you. All my ideas that I've come up with, my wife supported me on all my ideas. Every last one of them made money. Every last one of them. I got bored with line service. I said, man, I'm real. Beat myself down, I'm tired. I'm working at Brinks, cutting yards. I said, you gotta give me something better than this. I'm working dope. My body only go through so much. Got on my knees and asked God to show me another way. So we come up with another idea. Start the vending company. Yeah, this is easy. This is real easy. I understand this passive income thing now, so I can make money without even being there. So that wasn't enough money. So one day, I went inside this Red Robin restaurant. I saw the young guy in there mopping floors. But he looked so happy doing it. I said, wow, that's cool. So I became friends with this guy. And I just asked him, I said, hey, man. And that's when God gave me the idea. Boom, start your cleaning service. He gave me an idea. So I took that idea and ran with it. Every appeal, Pastor Hill asked, wanted us to do, me and my wife was a part of it. Every last one of them, we're not going to have any money. You see what I'm saying? That's what it's about. You can't be scared to give up this money. It ain't nothing but paper. That's all it is. So, I'm just a little bit deeper than that, but you know what I'm saying? That's all it is. It's paper. So, God trusts you. If He can't trust you with five, forget about 50. Don't even dream about 500. And don't even think about 5,000. Pastor Hill just asked for us to, everybody, not just a handful of us, everybody to step up. These kids that we see at this front row, that was me and my brother. That's the honest God truth. Like I said, I come from zero. I don't want to tell you all my net worth, but I.
All right. Well, I'm going to tell you this net worth. And I tell you, it's amazing what God can do. Amen. People obey Him and love Him. It was the last go around.
Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness. That is Waymaker, miracle worker, promise keeper, light in the darkness, my God, that is who you are. You are here, moving in our midst. I worship you. I worship you.